Limits and continuity. We say that fxi approaches the limit L as the point xy approaches the point A, B, and write lim fxi approaches A, B equal L. In other words, we can make the values of f as close to L as we like by taking the point xy sufficiently close to point AB. A more precise definition follows. Definition. We say that limit approaches AB f x y is equal L, provided that for every positive small number epsilon, there exists a positive number delta, such that absolute value f x y minus L is smaller than epsilon whenever absolute value x minus A is smaller than sigma and y minus B is smaller than delta. Or zero is smaller than root x minus a square plus y minus b square is bigger than is smaller than delta. The set of all points lying inside the circle of radius delta centered at B. The function of a single variable when x approaches to A, we let x approach to A, there are only two possible paths. There are only two possible paths, from the left or from the right. For functions of two variables, there are infinite number of paths in which we can approach the point AB in the XY plane. AB point. There are an infinite number of paths. If the limit exists, then f must approach the same limit CL, no matter how XY approaches AB, if the limits exist, then FXE must approach the same limit. No matter how XY approaches AB. If FXY L1 as XY approaches to AB along a path C1 and FXI L2 as XY AB along a path C2 where L1 is not equal to L2, then limit F XI approach to AB does not exist. Please carefully. It is not necessary that L is equal to FAB even if FAB is defined. This is important. Definition. Is about continuity at a point. Let F be a function that is defined for all points XY close to the point AB, then F is continuous at the point AB if limit F approaches to AB is equal to FAB. If the graph of FXY does not have a hole or gap at AB, the function of is continuous at point AB, otherwise F is said to be discontinuous there. Epsilon delta definition of continuity. If given any epsilon is bigger than zero, there exists a sigma is equal sigma epsilon is bigger than zero such that absolute of f xy minus FAB is smaller than epsilon whenever x minus a is smaller than delta and y minus b smaller than delta, or 0 is smaller than root x minus a square plus y minus b square is smaller than delta. Epsilon delta definition. Theorem. Suppose that limit f approach to AB is equal to L1 and limit gxy approach to AB is equal to L2 and K is a constant. Then A limit approach to AB f plus minus x y g equal to l1 plus minus l2. B limit approach to AB k times f is equal to k times L1. C limit approach to AB f times g is equal to L1 times L2. Similarly, D limit approach to AB f xy divided g is equal to L1 divided L2 if L2 is not equal to 0. And theorem 2. If k is a real number and f and g are continuous at AB, then the following functions are continuous at AB. A k times f. Scalar multiple. B. F plus minus g. Sum and difference. C. F product g. Product. D. F divided g if g a b is not equal zero. These functions are continuous at a b. Now, iterated limits. In multivariable calculus, an iterated limit is an expression of the form limit approach to b and limit x approach to a f x y or limit x approach to a limit y approach to b f x y. These are not defined in the same way as the limit are not defined in the same way limit x y approach to a b f x y. Iterated limits in generally does not imply anything about limit x y approach to a b f x y. Does not involve first taking one limit and then another and vice versa. Theorem. If limit xy approaches to ab f exists and one of the iterated limits exists, then they are equal but one can exist without the other. Now, let us recall some important limits of functions of single variable. They are subject of the calculus 1. Limit x approach to 0 sinus x divided x is equal to 1. Limit x approach to infinity sinus x divided x is equal to 0. Limit x approach to 0 tangent x divided x is equal to 1. Limit is x approaches to 0, x product sin 1 divided x is equal to 0. Limit x approaches to infinity, x product sin 1 divided x is equal to 1.